off of the gram. Bitches love the gram.
Oh, wait, shit.
Roxanne, Roxanne, all she wanna do is party all night. Goddamn, Roxanne, never gonna love me, but it's alright. She think I'm an asshole, she think I'm a player. She keep running.
Good morning, YouTube. I'm in Australia. I'm in the Daintree Rainforest at Silky Oaks Resort. It's beautiful. Got the pool down there.
But it's thrill, yeah. Shorty drive a poodle with no top. But if I throw this money, she gon' drop. She don't wait in lines if it's too long. She don't drive the whip unless the roof fall. Only wanna call when the cash out. Only take the pick when the ass out. She from Malibu, Malibu. If you ain't got a foreign, then she laugh at you. Malibu, Malibu. Spending daddy's money with an attitude. Roxanne, Roxanne. All she wanna do is party all night.
This is crazy.
She think I'm a player. She keep running back though, only cause I pay her. Roxanne, Roxanne. All she wanna do is party all night.
I
just
wanna have fun.
In LA, yeah. Got no brakes, yeah. Living fast, Ricky Bobby shaking bait, yeah. See the chain, yeah. It's a late, yeah. Swipe the chase, ooh. Now she wanna date, yeah. Straight and no boo. Coast, shorty only like cocaine and Whole Foods. Yeah, snapping all up on the grandmas, going crazy. Now she wanna fuck me in the foreign, going A's. I'm from Malibu, Malibu. If you ain't got a foreign, then she laugh at you. Malibu, Malibu. Spending daddy's money with an attitude.
Okay, so we finished our hike. Fun hike, almost broke my camera a few times. Besides that, we went swimming. Yeah, it was pretty fun.
She think I'm an asshole. She think I'm a player. She keep running back though, only cause I pay her. Roxanne, Roxanne. All she wanna do is party all night.
Black leather glove, no sequins. Buckles on the jacket, it's elite shit. Nike crossbody, got a piece in it. Gotta dance, but it's really on some street shit. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we bout to slide. Hey, can't let this one slide. Hey. Don't you wanna dance with me? No, I could dance like Michael Jackson. I could get you the passion. It's a thriller in a trap. Where we from? Baby, don't you wanna dance with me? No, I could dance like Michael Jackson. I could get you satisfaction. And you know we out here every day with it. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we bout to slide. Hey, can't let this one slide. Hey. 2,000 shorties wanna tie the knot, hey, yeah. 200 shooters on my brother's block, oh, yeah. Pedal off a rose like I love a knot, baby, not. I don't know what's wrong with me, I can't stop, oh, yeah. Won't stop, oh, yeah. Never stop. Got so many ops, I'll be mistaken.
You might go, dial the number and it starts to ring. And then it's basically,
yeah,
it's about to creep where they staying. Black leather glove, no sequins. Buckles on the jacket, it's elite shit. Nike crossbody, got a piece in it. Gotta dance, but it's really on some street shit. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we bout to slide. Hey, can't let this one slide. Hey. 2C slide, then I hit it double time, then I hit a spin, cause we spun that block a couple times. If it's not the right time, it'll always be another time. I'm not even tripping, we'll just see them in the summertime, whoa, yeah. Can't describe the pressure I be putting on myself, yeah. Really, I just can't afford to lose nobody else, yeah. If they moving shaky, we'll just do the shit ourselves, well. If I'm moving shaky, Chels will do the shit himself, yeah. Solo niggas on a YOLO for real. Heard a lot about you, but we don't know for real. Next time, guarantee the truth will get revealed. Black leather glove, no sequins. Yeah, buckles on the jacket, it's elite shit. Nike crossbody, got a piece in it. Got a dance, but it's really on some street shit.
Nature's showing us these pathways. The problem is we're chopping trees down so fast that we're missing out on incredible opportunities. The World Wildlife Fund reckons we're losing up to 200 species from our planet, not every year. Every single day, and we can't afford that loss, because I reckon you can measure the health and the wealth of planet Earth in its biodiversity. And so it's a pretty sad state we're in, and we have time to fix things up if we have the willpower to do it. But this process of fruiting and flowering on the trunk of a tree is called cauliflory. It's restricted pretty much to tropical rainforests. It allows different animals to pollinate and to predate the fruit and so on. And it's one reason we can have such a high diversity of trees in a small area. In fact, the best 2.5 acres of Amazonian rainforest in Peru contain more species of native trees than you'll find in the whole of the United Kingdom. And that's a remarkable statistic, because you can walk around 2.5 acres in a few minutes. And to walk across the British Isles takes a long time. And so it just gives you an example of just how diverse rainforests are. Okay, we just moved to an American part of the garden, and there's a plant from the Amazon which actually helped you get here today. Can anybody think what kind of plant might have helped them get here today?
Rubber.
Yeah, okay. This is a rubber tree. If you look closely, I'll bring it out. I'll peel it and bring it out. You can see how elastic this sap is. Every airplane tire in the world is 100% natural rubber. Because really? It's the strongest chemical bond we know of in any chemistry that's ever been created or studied, through the carbon bond through the process of vulcanization. Now, a lot of car tires have lots of petrochemicals and plastics in them and so on, but rubber is the best and the most movable of all the tires and flexible. But rubber is not just in tires, it's in some of our sporting shoes, it's the center of golf balls, it's in tennis balls, it's in thousands of products that we consume on a day, or we use on a daily basis, including things like latex gloves, condoms, elastic bands, and so on. So we have probably over 2,000 different products that are based on latex, or the sap from a rubber tree. 200 years ago, Indians glued feathers on their arrows. They made bowls out of it. They patched holes in their water vessels. They had no idea of the uses that we have today for rubber. And this is just one species of plant from the rainforest. What does the rest of the rainforest hold? Well, we don't know, and we don't actually have enough scientists studying it, because almost everybody who goes into university today wants to go into technology. We're missing out on some of the natural sciences. But there's two other plants here I want to talk about from the Amazon, which are really important. And one of them is this vine. The Indians found that they could make a potion from the bark of this vine so they could see at nighttime. Whoa. And what happens is they take the bark, they mash it up, and they put it in a vessel of water and they boil it. And when it gets to the right consistency, if they can drink it, it dilates the pupils of their eyes to fill up almost the whole of the iris. Now, the problem with it is it's very bitter and almost everybody throws up. So the Indians were smart. The Indians were smart. Here, you want the rubber? They went in the forest and they found this leaf. It's a particular leaf called Cecropia. And they toasted it over the fire. And when it was fully toasted, they powdered up the ash and they put it in this brew with the bark in it. And what is ash rich in? But calcium and magnesium. So it's a bit like milk of magnesia. It stopped people from throwing up. So more and more people could drink this brew and see at nighttime. So what did they do? They went out chasing men or women or hunting or fishing or fighting or playing or whatever. We could send our top scientists in the jungle today and say, come back when you can see at nighttime. If they didn't learn from the indigenous people, we'd probably never see these scientists again. They'd either die of old age, get eaten, get sick and disease or whatever. What these plants illustrate to me is the importance of traditional knowledge in our understanding of our environment. Now, I've been to a lot of conservation projects around the world. When the last chimpanzee disappears from a piece of forest, the forest disappears. They're only trying to save the chimpanzees. Well, we have to be smarter than that because the forest contains more than chimpanzees. So for us land-based creatures, I identify four really important pillars that belong in conservation. It starts with green plants because we're here as guests of green plants. Mm-hmm. The animals need them. The second pillar is the animals because the plants need the animals and vice versa. And believe it or not, about 90% of conservation funding goes to save animals, not plants. And that's because we relate to a face. So whether it's a whale or a frog or a bird or whatever, we want to save it. And that's great. I don't care where the money comes from. The third pillar should be the indigenous people. They've lived in these areas for thousands of years without destroying it, and they got this incredible knowledge which benefits us. And we're the fourth pillar. We're the ones who want to save it. We often have the money to do it. And if we work together and we create a strong foundation, we can be more successful. So that's what these plants teach me, is we have to work together, we have to learn from everybody else, and we have to be really careful and selective on where we spend our money, because there's a limited amount.
I'ma show you how it go. Right foot up, left foot slide, left foot up, right foot slide. Basically I'm saying either way we about to slide, hey, can't let this one slide, hey. Don't you want to dance with me?
The tree above us, you can see these yellow hairy fruits.
Yeah.
There's a red form of it in another part of the garden where I collected these. This is a plant from the Amazon, which is called Bixa. And you use it almost every day of your lives and probably never realized you had a connection with the Amazon. Inside this fruit are some seeds. Whoa. And around these seeds is a natural coloring. And I'll just use a few of them to show you how dramatic it is.
Oh my God.
Wow.
But the coloring is actually called annatto. And
the red in food.
It's the red in food, that's right. It'll oxidize redder than it is. This is sort of orangey. It'll oxidize with oxygen, turn much redder. But the beauty of it is it's not poisonous. It's water soluble, has no taste and no odor. It's used in a number of cosmetics. It makes many of our butters, margarines, and cheeses yellow. It's used in pastry making to give them a golden color, whether they're undercooked or overcooked a minute or two. In a normal Western supermarket, you'll find it in somewhere between 400 and 500 different products.
Wow.
So things like potato chips and jams and fruit juices and sauces and all sorts of different things. Sometimes farmers will mix it in the food for chickens, so the yolks of the eggs come up a darker color. And they've even used this in zoos to keep flamingos pink. Because flamingos need to eat a crustacean, which eats a particular algae, to turn pink. And when they don't have that diet, they turn white. Everybody wants pink flamingos, so they feed them a natural coloring or a synthetic one, and they turn pink.
No, I could dance like Michael Jackson. I could give you the passion. It's a thriller in a trap. Where we from? Baby, don't you wanna dance with me? No, I could dance like Michael Jackson. I could get you satisfaction. And you know we out here every day with it. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right.
The sunny's on? Yeah. Push your arm out. As hard as you can. Resist. Pretty impressive. The sunny's go on. Put your arm out and Lewis gonna go. Now you can see that's really actually pretty impressive. Wanna go to sunny's? You ready?
Yeah.
On your left, you will see the left side of Australia. On to your right, you will see the right side of Australia.
Oh no.
You may think that the steering wheel is on the wrong side of the road, and I'm gonna say that you're right. Back here with Taste Test with Ryan and Cole.
And Will.
Today's special guest, we have Mac and Will.
Hi.
We are trying the M berry, but in its natural form as a berry.
I'm in.
So these seeds turn sour things sweet, and right now we're cutting lemon.
Alright, everybody.
So we're gonna taste the lemon,
without the berry.
Sour. Without the berry, then we're gonna get the juice from the berry, and then taste the lemon again, and it should taste really sweet.
Again. okay, yep, that's sour.
Taste test.
Very sour. Alright, so we'll cut back to you when we have finished
it. So, a minute or two. Like.
Alright. 3, 2, 1. Now we try the lemon again. Whoa, it's sweet.
Oh, it is. It is a little sweeter.
It's like lemonade. You're out of your mind. I'm patiently waiting. It's coming with time, and I don't think I'm ever giving up. The sunset on my side is just enough. So where do I go?